All right, we meant to start this a little bit earlier, but we are on our way to the Gravely 100th anniversary show in West Virginia.
Point Pleasant, West Virginia.
Point Pleasant, West Virginia.
Yeah.
And we got the F-150 here, which is supposed to be all Gravely orange, but it decided to rain the last few days and we put it off too long. So we're sorry. Maybe we'll paint it at this side of the road, like Roadkill, when we find an auto parts place. But we got our nice lawn mowing tractor. It's our workhorse. It's all in there. And then we got a couple of the older guys. This one, hopefully. Of course, neither one wanted to work when we went to put it in, so I have to show you what's wrong with them once we get to the show. But figured show you guys here. We're at some weird ass McDonald's that's across the highway. Let's see if I can show. Well, I guess really, I don't have to go over there because you can see over there. I go across. So, thought that's pretty cool. Well, yeah, U-Haul. Tranny fluid is, but then I forgot about that and we never checked it. So then now we're stuck on the side of the road and it's raining. So we're trying to put some oil in the tranny. It freaking stopped. We're gonna see, but here we go. Anyways, it's raining, so I'm gonna stop. Okay, so we just had some fun. You see, we made a little mess. Sorry about that. This old power steering stop leak and a hose from one of the Gravelys, and we stole some oil from the Gravely. So now it has power steering fluid, power steering stop leak, and oil in the transmission. But thankfully it's a standard and the clutch has stopped boiling, so Angie's going to see if it starts, and then if it drives we're going to get it.
Let the clutch out and let the tranny spin.
In second.
In neutral. No, in neutral. Just let it spin.
Try and rev it up and do that.
dying.
Try like flooring it, do that? Like kind of floor it?
Our tranny's dick, we broke something. What gear are we in?
Second.
I think second.
Try, does it move anywhere? Oh shit, the tranny's working, Andrew?
Oh yeah,
whoa, whoa, you better steer it straight, buddy. Oh, okay, well, all right, well, it didn't work.
No, didn't end up working.
We didn't get a lift kit either. Well, now we have a fun night ahead of us. We get to see, we're going to a guy's shop, who's hopefully gonna let us work there or something. And yeah, see about getting a training from another guy, I think is the plan. So thanks to this guy for coming. I'll show you his truck in a minute. He's a cool guy so far. Oh yeah,
what,
I should have got a shot of that. Well, it turns out on our little run in here, we ran out of transmission fluid and literally smoked the transmission. So we have bought another one, and we are here at this lovely yard of the towing company, and he is a very nice guy, and he's helping us out amazingly. Very good people, and there's the cutest little kitties running around. Come visit us while we're working. Here's one ready to jump up his leg. Watch, he's gonna jump up his leg.
Attacking my shoelaces.
This has got to be the cutest cat ever. He just wants to sit and purr in your arms. That's pretty funny. Sanders under changing the transmission. There we go, under there. And it's going well so far. Little kitty, want to look?
There's a little kitty. Hi, little kitty. Hey, little kitty. Oh, you're going to attack my shoelace.
There's a little kitty cat. Yeah.
There. I'll get down there again. Hi, little kitty. Oh. Hi, little kitty. There you go. You should get it from this angle.
Right. We finally got the transmission in. Got everything sorted out, and how about that? We're driving. It's only super dark out right now, but Sanders on at the wheel there, and we're just giving her a little test drive. And yeah, we're just pulling back up at Keith's Towing. And here's a sweet truck. You might have caught that, a little glimpse of that.
Keith, who may be the coolest person in the world.
Yeah, Keith, who may be the nicest, coolest guy ever. Did a huge solid for us, let us use his place as our workshop so we could get everything back together. See some of his cool things. It's a little dark right now, unfortunately.
Yeah,
but this is Rat Rod, a nice Studebaker Rat Rod, 350 Chevy in it. With Farber front end, not a Mustang 2 front end on that bad boy. Anyways, we'll catch you guys up in a minute.
All right, I'm not sure how much you can see, but we have the truck hooked back up to the trailer. Oh, transmission's done. Can you see this little thing? What's this? Oh, it's gone. But yeah, so nicely, Keith from Keith's Towing called a guy in town who's got a wrecking yard, and he got us a nice transmission. So, thankfully it worked. It was from a 95. Of course, I had to put in two times, change the throw-out bearing to the right kind for this truck. But yeah, awesome. We can't thank him enough. That worked out too great. I'll show you just his thing. If you ever want, if you're ever in Ohio, and you need a good tower, if something happened to your car, you know, it's a serious guy. He's a good guy. Definitely call him up. He'll be there quick. He's there quicker than we've ever seen a tow truck show up in our life. But Yeah, just want to show you his nice little Studebaker truck here. I'm not sure if Andrew took anything earlier, but this is an awesome truck. He's made this basically on his free time. And you can see there's not a thing on it that is not custom. It is awesome. And you think that, oh, he just parks this here. No, it was out driving in the rain earlier, and he's driven this all over. He drove it to Tennessee, he said. It's got a 350 Firebird front end and a Studebaker pickup. Awesome. Yeah, definitely call Keith Towing. He'll help you out. I won't say he'll fix your car, but he probably will if you pay him. Very cool, man. Can't thank him enough. Firing up another nice dude. Oh yeah. Oh. That sounds awesome. Gear drive. Awesome. This one a little bit less modified, but still badass. That's awesome. All right, well, now we are done for the night. The truck works when we're at a hotel. We're not sleeping under the truck after all that.
No.
So, sweet. Thanks for Andrew helping. Thanks for Dad for buying a new tranny. Well, not a new one. Hopefully our new tranny is good.
Yeah.
But yeah, so we'll update you guys tomorrow. Hopefully we get some actual Gravelys.
Yeah, Gravely show.
All right, so we got a nice night. I don't know if you can see the sleep in here. And I think it's like Bolvia, Ohio. Let me see if I can see the box. Yeah. Boulevard. It's basically where we are. Got F-150. Not broken. I hope. Trailer. All the Gravelys. It's like 8 o'clock and we're headed to the show now. We'll get hopefully at least a day at the show. That'd be nice. Andrew, Dad. They're happy. Truck's fixed. Time to go.
We're here. We made it.
Woo. West Virginia.
All the oil seemingly did come out of the old transmission. It wasn't just dry. And it's all on the bottom of the truck. So when we started going up some hills and the exhaust got warm, it started dripping on the exhaust. And smoke was coming out the back and we were like, oh crap, we're in trouble now. But it was just exhaust, or oil dripping on the exhaust. Transmission's good. We've been keeping on top. But yeah, wanted to show you we got to West Virginia finally. And thanks for watching.
Oh, we're going around a pretty cool bridge here.
Yeah. Oh, look at that wall too.
The wall all done up and nice. Yep. Kind of neat. That's a nice little bridge span here. Never seen anything like this in Canada. Have I been out in BC maybe? Pretty cool. And then looking out here, nice Ohio River. This side here. There's everybody driving. Andrew doing the duties. Very nice. We're almost there.
Yeah.
been a long trip. Anyways, okay, see you back in a bit.
Okay, yeah, we're
mowing tractor service.
Yeah, we're arriving now. Pretty busy, I see. Lots of people around. Here we are offloading. We got here pretty late, so everything's running a little behind. Okay, I'll just close down. We'll close it up here. We'll see what we do later.
Hard drive.
All right, we're here at the show. My dad's got the old Gravely here. He's got a stuck valve again because we let it sit for a little bit. So he's just gonna try and free that up so we can start it up. But this guy's working good as always. We just thought we'd give you a brief overview of first. Probably check out some cool stuff after, show you a little closer. Okay, so we have left the meet. That was very cool. Everyone had fun. Dad's back there. He got a few things. Oh, yeah, I guess we'll show you what we got. Right now, we're just gonna double check the training fluid before we go have dinner, so we don't get too dirty. Well, you can kind of see there. So sneak peek, 40-inch deck. Needs an idler pulley, supposedly. We'll see. Sure, it needs some other things, like probably weld a patch at the back. But then we can have a walk behind, you know, maybe this guy, or something else for just in case. And yeah, do smaller stuff. But truck worked good, tractors work good. Well, okay, we didn't get this one going. But that's okay. Not enough time, wanted to have some fun and relax, so. Yeah, but anyways, we're gonna check training fluid, top it up if necessary, and then go have some dinner for our long drive home. But talk to you soon. Well, if you notice the toolkit, we're having some more fun. Thankfully not a big deal though. Our toolkit's just out so we could top up the tranny. This one leaks pretty bad out of the rear main seal, so we're really, you know, babying it and trying to make sure it's full. Don't want to hurt it. But the problem we had and why we really had to stop is the frickin' heater core. Oh, of course you can't see anything. Is the light still here? No. Anyways, the heater core has blown, which would be not too surprising or a big deal if it wasn't friggin' new. Of course, had to buy a cheap one. Don't buy cheap crap. But otherwise, working good. Just having a little bit of coolant inside to make it stinky, so yeah. Anyways, thought I'd show you guys that. End of our trip. Well, not end of our trip. Currently, we're in Ohio at a 7-Eleven. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah. Yeah. But we'll tell you when we are home or almost home. And hopefully, we don't have to work on anything else.
All right, everybody. So we're finally made it into Canada again. Didn't want to really film at the border or anything. Don't want to cause any suspicions or anything. But yeah, just in case. But here's proof of the pudding. If we'll even catch it, probably not. 100 kph. Start us off for a split second. So we're in Canada. Woo! Everybody's happy. Can't see him. Sorry to see Dad's glasses, but everybody's happy. So finally back to Canada. It's only friggin' it's only 3:40 in the morning, and yeah, so we're doing pretty good. So I'm back on my home network again, so sweet. Alright, well, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll give you a little update probably in the morning, so take her easy.